Hello guys, and welcome to a new StudDivision 2 video today by me, Vulcan. In this video, I am going to be joined by AtkPwr as we make a 10 versus 10 deck for him to play with me in a 10v10 game. It was a lot of fun, and hopefully will help some of you guys if you're making 10v10 decks in the future. But let's get into it. I'm going to get you into the 10v10s. That's going to be great.
Oh, I'm so excited to wait for a half hour to find a game. Nothing could be more exciting than that.
Yeah. So you already decided what deck you wanted to make, and that was the 78th Sturm, right?
Yes, that is the right one for me. It has to be Axis. I love my Axis divisions too much. Oh, and don't forget, hit that like button and subscribe, everyone. It really helps both our channels out a lot.
Yep, it does indeed. All right, so the 78th Sturm is actually a really good pick, I think, for like a 10v10 specific deck, because it has super strong infantry. Or at least it does at high veterancy. I think MP44s benefit a lot from veterancy.
Yeah, and I think also it has a lot of tools, like in the anti-tank tab, to reach out and kill some of those super heavy tanks. And it also has a nice AA tab. It has all the things I think I need for a 10v10.
There we go. I called it AtkPwr 10v10 for you.
Oh, I don't get a cool name. That's fine.
So where do you start in a deck? Let's do it your way this time.
I start on infantry, because okay. I want many of them.
Infantry is very good in this deck.
Yes, they are, and I love them all. So I'm not a huge... I don't feel like Ersatztruppen are the way to go in 10v10. Am I right about that?
Yeah. I mean, they're probably not going to... You're not going to have enough points to really use them.
You probably want to use quality over quantity. Yeah, so are we playing a normal 10v10 or like the tactical low point 10v10?
Whichever has people in it, but you can kind of build them for both. Generally, if you're going tactical, you're going to be like higher veterancy, more specific, but you can do quality regardless, and it works in both.
Okay, so let's scroll down there to the Schützen, of course. We need some of them bad boys.
The double machine
vet.
Guns.
Yep, one vet, of course. And let's put two of them in A. That's two cards in A. Yep, okay. Opal Blitzes, that's all you get. Let's put a card of Sturmschützen in there as well.
The veterancy card's kind of trash on these.
Yeah, definitely not double. Okay, so how do you... Actually, a lot of times in Phase A, I take Sturmschützen unvetted, because I feel like at the 300-meter distance, they're doing... good damage anyway.
You have another option.
I have the Beglites. I'm just concerned about availability. Having only three.
Is that enough
in 10v10?
You can very easily go 3-1, 4-1 with these. In terms of infantry squads. For me, Beglites are a must take. Like Beglite Pioneers.
I like taking the Grenadiers and B. I take the Beglite Grens and B often.
The other thing that's really important to think about when you're making a 10v10 deck is you're unlikely to have enough points to buy a commander. Somebody usually will that you can use as well, because obviously the map's smaller and there's more people.
Oh, so it shares?
Yeah, it does. But the nice thing about having higher veterancy troops by default is that your leaders can, say, for example, in this case, push a 2-vet to a 3-vet without the need of a commander.
Yeah.
Which is really useful.
Speaking of leaders, let's get one in there. Schützenführer, I believe, is the... Or, wait. Can we do the Pioneerführer instead? Is he 3? Can you get 3 Pioneerführers?
Yeah, you can get 3
in A. Yeah, let's do that one, because he's only 20 points, and I like the grenade, personally.
Yep, it's good for trading.
Yeah, for emergency, like, if he's going to die, he's going to take someone with him. So how is 15 infantry in A for 10v10? Do I need more?
It depends. Are you going to go Juggernaut, or are you... We didn't even talk about this. Do you want to go Juggernaut, or do you want to go Balance? Because
I was going to go Balance. I do like a little bit... I think Balance is fine. I don't think the 20-point difference at the end is doing it for me.
Yeah, so bear in mind, you in a normal 10v10, you get 0.75 income per minute.
Okay.
And in a tactical 10v10, you get half. So it would be like Phase A would be 55 points per minute. Ooh. In Phase B, you'd be, I don't know what it halves it to, but yeah, it goes down quite a lot.
Oh, yeah, let's stick with Balance. I don't like having nothing in B.
Okay.
So
yeah. This would be okay if you're considering bringing stuff in other areas. Yeah, for sure.
All right, let's go with that for now. Phase B, let's do a card of shoots in, one vet. And actually, just throw a card, unvetted card in C while we're at it.
Really? You want...
Oh, you think unvetted? I should vet? Or unvetted? Yeah.
You should almost always vet them in C, yeah, as well.
Really?
Yeah.
See, in 1v1, you usually do one card of unvetted.
So games are capped at an hour in 10v10. There's a time limit. So you got to bear in mind that you might not bring them all in.
Okay. All right. Fine. Yeah. You are the expert. Throw them vetted. let's go Beglycrens in B. One vet's fine. Yeah.
Yep.
And then I do want a card of Sturmschützen somewhere. Do we just put them in B, do you think? Or do I wait till C?
So Sturmschützen, due to their like availability curve, aren't as good in this deck. You'd probably want something that's more specialized towards close range. And then you've got your Schützen for like your long range engagements, right?
Okay, fine. We'll take Pioneers, I guess, then.
I think the only way that it would work is if you potentially brought like extra Sturmschützen in C, maybe if you're doing like a Juggernaut, it might work. Sturmschützen are the king of light cover, right? They really are.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And town engagements, so. Yeah, it depends. All
right, what if we do a card of Pioneers in C and a card of Sturmschützen in B?
Like maybe unvetted?
Just one vet. Yeah. Let's see how that does. Let's go with that. Let's hop back to Recon. There's not much choice here.
No, 78 Sturm has a very anemic Recon tab.
Yeah, I mean, Alf Glares for sure. Probably in the Kubel Jeeps. MGs.
Yep.
For people who don't know, the Kubel MG will stick around because it's worth points, and it does have, you know, it does have recon
because
optics as well. One thing I always kick around, I always wonder whether I should be vetting the recon, because vetting does increase their optics. It doesn't say so, but it does.
In 10v10, it's less important because there's just generally more units on the field, so.
Okay. How do you feel about Panzer T26s? T26s are really good for 20 points. I'm not going to lie.
No.
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 No, these trade so
quality
well.
Quality over quantity. And also, is it worth 2 points? Probably not.
I don't think so, but they are a 1v1 standout, I will say.
Yeah, I don't think they're worth it in this case.
Oh, I hate those. No, I hate the four-man recon teams. I am not a fan.
All right, yeah. Do you want anything else in here?
It'll just have to be that for now. If we have extra points, we'll come back.
Yeah, that's totally fine.
Infantry done. Tank. Oh, so many options here. So this is what I'm thinking. I'm thinking it's either one or double vet in A. Let's go double vet A. Okay, and then we're going to do a single vet in B and in a C. Single vet in C. Yep.
Really?
And then the leader in B to fill in the curve.
Okay.
There. That gives me tanks in all the phases. Do you think I should double vet?
Yeah, double vetting this phase C Stukes would probably be fine as well.
Okay. Go ahead, double vet them up. Make them awesome.
Yeah, you just gotta, again, it's all about quality in 10v10. And Stukes at 2 vet are just so good. It's like 10
they
round per minute
really
rate
good.
Of fire.
Yeah, they actually really function quite well. They're my favorite medium tank in turn, honestly.
Yeah, very nice. All right.
Lovely.
Support
to the
tab.
Support tab.
One of the best support tabs in the game.
And you know we're putting those flamers in.
Why?
Because I'm telling you to. This is the one thing you're going to suck up. No, I don't even want them vetted. I want 6 unvetted flamers.
Okay. There's no real priority for the middle of the map, but sure.
I'm going to make so much use of those. I'm telling you right now.
All right.
I definitely want the IG-33, not the IG-18. 33.
Okay.
Now, the question is, in A or B, what do you think?
Do you want them with multi-munition trucks?
No. I want them the STKFZ-11. They're the faster.
Yeah. I would say A, for sure.
A, yeah. Don't vet them, because I do need 3. They're probably going to die. I mean, I guess Opel Blitz munitions, probably in B.
Okay.
I'm going to need something. Machine guns. We love our machine guns, our MG42s. A one vet.
Yeah.
I think it's worth losing one to have one vet on. Can we take them in the Hirsches? Or is it Kubels only?
Yeah, take them
in the Hirsch. They're faster. The Hirsch is faster. And then a commandant.
The infantry commandant.
Yep. I like I can hide him everywhere. All right, I think that's pretty good.
I actually kind of like the Panzer II in this deck.
Seriously?
Yeah, it's just fun.
I just don't like I can't put them wherever
you
I want.
Okay, this is another thing you got to remember about 10v10. It's all about the fun, you know?
You're trying to stop my flamers. Flamers are fun, Vulcan. Flamers are fun.
Yeah, but so are more MGs, so.
Flamers are fun.
Do you want to put anything else in the support tab?
Let's leave it for now. If there's extra room, I will put more machine guns in.
Okay.
Oh, what a beautiful AT tab. It's so beautiful. Yes, we do have to take some Nashorns. It's just when to take them. Can we go B, one vet?
Yep.
I think that's probably good.
Bear in mind that in 10v10, players do like to start with heavy tanks. Because they are supported by their team generally, right?
So what? Should I just go? Because there's two more cards. We could go an unvetted card in A. I kind of want to save the pack 43s for B, so I have four of them to work with.
Okay. You want Nazlons like in A?
Yep. Okay. Two of them so I can double team a heavy tank. That's the concept here. And then the pack 43s in B at the bottom there. Yes. Can we bring them in the SDK of Z11s? Yes. Big guns. No vet, because I know they're going to die. I just know they're going to die a lot. And then we need pack 40s in A and B, for sure. Unvetted.
Okay.
Yes. I don't like my AT unvetted. It dies so much that I just need lots of it.
But high veterancy pack 40s are really good.
I'm not bringing one pack 40.
No, I mean, one vet pack 40s, if you put a leader with them, that makes them two vet. They get 13 round per minute rate of fire. You make them three vet with a commander, they're just like pumping. They absolutely
okay,
pump.
Okay, fine. You've convinced me. I do want the next card in B, though.
You do also have a Nashorn.
Yeah, in reality, the Nashorn is not very good. I'm just going to note.
In phase B, the veterancy is not really worth it. So.
No, because now you're losing two. Like, now you're really getting hurt. So, Vernichtungs or Panzerschrecks?
It's up to you, really. Whatever you prefer.
Vernichtungs are so good. But they are good. You get so many more Panzerschrecks. Like, in B, you can have eight Panzerschrecks, and that's nice. You're not going to argue with me. I'm not going to vet my Panzerschrecks, right? You're not going to have that argument with me?
No.
They basically don't miss as is.
Yeah, they're 90% accurate. They don't need veterancy.
They already don't miss. What would you do? You tell me what you would do here.
I would probably take two cards. I'd probably take Vernichtungs in A.
And Panzerschrecks in B. Let's go with that. I'm just worried about the points we have going on here, but we'll shave back if we have to.
Yep.
A, off we go. So, okay. I mean, I love my 37 mils. Are they any good? Are they not good in 10v10?
No, they're pretty good. Yep.
Delightful. Then let's one vet them in A and B.
Yep, that's totally fine.
And then one card of 88s in B, I think. Unvetted.
In B?
In B.
Okay.
Or am I misinterpreting how air spammy 10v10 is going to be?
It can get very air spammy.
In A already, or is it usually towards B phase?
It would be towards the late game, when people start buying in their 20 bombers.
So C card, you're saying?
Yes.
That's totally fine. I was going to say either B or C with these things. It's either one's fine.
Yeah, that works out well.
All right, cool. Artillery then. The arty party. Now, usually I am a battery fear, like, gotta take it. Because we only have three leaders. A card in B would give me the seven I like to have. Is that is that kosher with you?
It's totally fine.
Can we take the Nebel Warfers in B? I do love them for killing singular targets with the munitions.
All right. I'm not a massive fan of Nebuvetha's asshole, but yeah, fair enough.
I like being able to take out frontline stuff, and they're really cheap. It's honestly a really cheap rate to do it.
I think in a 10v10 they work well, so yeah, it'd be a good choice.
Should I take the 150 mils or not? The FH18? Is it worth it, or am I not committed enough in C? I'm talking like in C phase.
You could definitely bring them in C if you wanted to. But the main thing is, if you're not committing entirely to artillery, these would be almost entirely for counter battery rather than supporting your own troops. Because it's there's a very fine line between like you having to have like enough weight of artillery to suppress your opponent's artillery whilst also making it valuable to you to like arty the front line, right?
Yeah.
So that takes a lot of guns, and there are certain players who will definitely focus on a lot of artillery in a 10v10. So it
that's why I'm saying, is it like not worth it? Should I just go like the 210 off map instead? Is that better? Or
off map 100%. Just depends. All right,
let's go in. Can we do in B?
Sure.
I think a B is a nice middle ground.
You just got to think about when you're gonna push. Like for me, phase A off map is really good for getting like a foothold early in a 10v10. And then if you want to maybe play it a bit more slow, you'd probably be like phase C, and then you bring in all three at once and just obliterate the front line.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Yeah. This makes me throw up in my mouth. I'm not sure I'm going to do with this amount of spam. I really don't.
Yeah.
Let's put it in B. Let's just split the difference. Okay. I'm going to use my flamers to get my push in A.
Okay. Do you want anything else here?
Just to spite you. No, because we only have 3 points left, and I'm going to need fighters.
You don't want to...
Oh, do you want it to be a phase C card of Nebuvetha's? that seems like too much.
Let's have a look at the end tab before we do that, yeah.
All right, the BF-109 G6 R6.
A, B, or C?
A phase. Got to have something. Okay. Now, yes, the JU... The big booms. If I was going to bring in a bomber, that'd be it in probably C phase, I'd assume, right?
Okay, so if you're not bringing in more than 10 bombers, your bombers probably will get shot down very easily.
Oh, good lord.
Later in the game. Because if you think there's the equivalent of 10 people buying AA, like it's just not
going
to work.
Do I just not bring in bombers? Because I'm fine with that. I don't need to have
bombers. You can just bring them in like earlier on. And I think like in phase B, that is, again, a good middle ground. It's before the air spam comes in from players, which forces the anti-air spam, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So,
hell yeah.
So you have time to use them before, yeah.
Well, my decision here is between the bombers or another card of fighters. Like, is two cards of fighters to have, like, 10 fighters
worth it? You don't really
need fighters
because, again, AA is so prevalent.
Just so much. Oh, man. The other option is to hop back over into Arty tab and get more artillery.
So, yeah, if you're going to go all in with the Nebuvetha's, that could be just as devastating as having the triple off map, right? Having something that can really just clean people out is quite important. And particularly in this case, say if you were to run out of things that could kill big tanks like the IS-2s, then spamming them with Nebuvetha's is another way to do it.
You know, let's go with the C card of Nebuvetha's. All I need are some fighters. I don't need bombers. They're going to get shot down and I'm going to be frustrated.
Okay. So...
Let's see this thing. Let's see this beauty. What? What a delight.
It looks kind of ugly.
What? How dare you? Are you just talking about my poor flamers that you keep hating on?
Yeah, so I have this thing on my YouTube, on my Twitch channel where I give people ratings for their decks. And I go through like a lot of the units and I'd like say what I'd change and stuff. So, like, in this case, yeah, the flamers would change to MGs. I think looking at the AT tab now with the pack 40s added, you need to either put the Nashorns in C or put the pack 43s in C.
Oh, that's fine. No, we can make that change. Let's put the yeah, let's put the
I think the Nash ones would be better.
All right, let's put the Nash ones in B and C. Oh, but we should should we unvet them? How bad is that curve? Am I losing two or one Nashorn?
You're losing three.
Oh, I'm losing three. Oh. Yeah, I'm kind of... Yeah, I'm leaning towards that, honestly.
Okay.
You disagree? I mean, they're going to die a lot. I know, obviously, the veterancy helps, but, like, losing three of them for one vet seems like a lot.
The other thing for me here is I'm not sure you entirely need the five pack 40s in B if you're going to be having the pack 43s in B.
So is there not a lot of medium tank stuff?
So, yeah, it's more like people spam infantry, they spam heavy tanks, and they spam artillery and bombers. Those are like the four things. That
those are the things.
You're going to have to worry about. Medium tanks are less of a thing because they can't really dominate open ground in 10v10 because of the amount of heavy tanks that there are. And also... the amount of AT that there is between the amount of people you have. Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so let's do this. We'll take the pack 40s out and let's go add another card of machine guns. How about that?
Okay.
In B, yep, with a vet. How's that? Do you feel better about that?
Yeah, it's looking a bit better, for sure. You could definitely bring... I feel like the bombers would be nice, but I'm not sure where you'd find the points to bring those. Otherwise, yeah, it's totally okay.
I have a feeling I won't get any vet. The only thing I would...
Would you need
feel
the
like,
upper blitz?
I just don't want to run out of ammo with my Nebelwerfers. If I'm using them aggressively,
then you might as
they
well
run
them
out of
phase C, right?
Yeah, probably right. Sorry, that's a 1v1 habit, because usually I always take some sort of mortar in A, so the B card of munitions supplies the mortars.
So it's funny, earlier on, I asked you if you wanted your IGs and multiers. Because it's a really nice way to compact supply and the IG into one card so you can use them for your artillery tab. And in a 3v3 or a 4v4, you have the time to do that.
Yeah. So,
but yeah, in this case, you've used the multiers for all of your Nebelwerfers, so that's fine.
Yes, it will be a rocket raining down from the heavens.
I think overall this looks pretty good. No.
Delightful. I can't
the
wait.
Flammenwerfers.
Oh my god, I'm going to use those so hard.
You got the glites. Why do you need
them? I'm using them so hard.
The other thing that you could struggle with here is like the lack of close range infantry in the middle of the game. Because one thing you have to understand is that if you're not super fast at picking where you're going to go on the map, other people will pick for you. So you'll end up like having to cover an area that's not necessarily ideal for your deck.
Yeah.
So having some sort of versatility in there is sometimes useful.
Well, let's hope I end up in a town.
One can hope that there's a town on the map.
Yeah, that's my dream. A town.
All right. Okay.
Fantastic. We're ready. We're going to be diving on in here into a 10v10. Thank you, Vulcan, for creating this masterwork.
No worries.
So excited to dive in. If you guys enjoyed this content, please hit that like button and subscribe. And make sure you check out the game we're going to be posting.
Yep, looking forward to the 10v10. Catch you later, guys.
Fantastic day.